Hello students, so in this video let us discuss a demonstration of an experiment called verification of parallel axis theorem. So this experiment belongs to BSc first year. Okay, aim of this experiment is to verify the theorem of parallel axis for moment of inertia. Okay, so for this experiment we need the apparatus called bar pendulum, knife edge, stopwatch, meter scale and a physical balance. Okay, now the experiment is following the principle, so in which parallel axis theorem of moment of inertia states moment of inertia of a body about an axis parallel to the axis passing through the center of gravity is equal to the sum of the moment of inertia about the axis passing through the center of gravity and the mass times the square of the distance between the two axes. Okay, so now based on this principle, so we have the formulas are Ig is equal to m into l square plus b square by 12. Okay, so this is standard formula to calculate the moment of inertia about the center of gravity for the given body. Okay, similarly graphically the moment of inertia through center of gravity Ig is equal to intercept into m into g divided by 4 pi square. So experimentally you have to find the Ig in both the using both the equations. Okay, so in the above formula we are using the terms Ig as moment of inertia of the body about an axis passing through the center of gravity. Okay, so it can be measured in terms of kg meter square. Similarly using the physical balance you have to measure the mass. M is the mass of the body in kg, L is the length of the body measured in meter. Okay, B is the breadth of the body to be measured in meter again. So G is acceleration due to gravity. Okay, meter per second square is the unit. So normally the value will be given to you. So you have to enter the value of G as 9.8 meter per second square. Clear? Now look at the experimental arrangement. So there is a simple experimental arrangement. We are using a bar pendulum for the experiment. So you know there is a metallic bar pendulum like this. So in which there are certain number of holes, you can see that. So central hole can be considered center of gravity CG. Then on either side we have equal distant holes. Okay, so that the spacing between each holes is constant. And then we have a knife edge here. So this knife edge can be inserted through each hole and you can find the time taken for oscillations in the experiment, correct? So in this experiment we need to consider only one side holes, so other side holes are not necessary. You consider only one side holes. Every time you insert the knife edge from the first hole, then second hole, third hole, etc., you complete all the one sided holes here to find the time taken for oscillations. Okay, now look at the observations. We need to measure the mass of the body, that is m is equal to, okay, some value will get for the entire mass of this body in the physical balance. So write down that value in kg. Then using a meter scale find out the length of the entire bar pendulum, so enter that value here. Then using again a vernier calipers or even ordinary scale also you can just measure the width. Okay, so that is called breadth of the body here. So b. Then using this mass, length and breadth you can calculate the moment of inertia through the center of gravity of the body. Okay, we have the first formula for that. Then the second part of the experiment is you look at the experiment. Okay, now look at the tabular column. Here we mentioned the whole numbers. Okay, either it may be 7 or even 9 also sometimes. So if you just find out the distance of the hole from center of gravity, that is called d. Okay, so that means, so you just look at the diagram again. From this center of gravity to the first hole, this distance is measured here and entered as the first trial for the first hole. Then for second hole also you have to measure from center of gravity again. Similarly for third hole you have to measure the distance from center of gravity. So like that you enter the distances of all the holes from center of gravity here. Clear? Then then okay. So this bar pendulum should be oscillated like this about its mean position. Then you can find out the time taken for either 10 oscillations or 20 oscillations. Okay. So here it is mentioned time for 20 oscillations in seconds. So in two trials, that is T1 and T2. What do you mean by that? You are repeating the experiments two times for each whole number. Okay. So find out the time taken for 20 oscillations. Repeat the experiment again for the same whole. Write down this as T2. So mean of this T1 and T2 is taken as mean T. Okay. Then the next column, period. So capital T is equal to T by 20. That means this mean value, small t, should be considered and divided by 20. Okay. If it is done for only 10 oscillations, then you have to divide by 10. Like that it is. So calculate the period of oscillation. Time taken for one oscillation is called period of oscillation. So capital T is calculated for all the trials here. Okay. Then the further calculation is about d square. So that means we have already d, distance between the hole and center of gravity. So we just calculate the d square in the next column. Then next to that we have the column to be calculated as t square into d. So we have here itself capital T. So just you have to multiply t square to this value of d. Should be calculated and entered into the last column. Okay. So once we have finished the calculation for all the trials, you have to take a graph sheet and plot the graph. Okay. So in the graph sheet, you consider the values of d square from the table column along x-axis. Okay. Take all the d square values along x-axis. And the corresponding d square d should be taken along y-axis. So once you get certain experimental points, so if you draw a line, okay, that line should be a straight line in the parallaxis theorem. So that this straight line is going to intercept along y-axis at this point. Okay. So the intercept is equal to 4 pi square into ig divided by m into g. Okay. So this, using this formula only, you can calculate the ig, because experimentally you are finding the intercept. So then you can calculate by cross multiplication what is the value of ig. Okay. So in that way we can find the moment of inertia in two methods: by the standard theoretical formula using mass, length and breadth, and then using graphically also you can find the value of g. And these two values of moment of inertia through the center of gravity of the given body can be compared later. Okay. Now let us go to the experiment, and I will show you how to perform the experiment to find the time taken for at least 10 oscillations for the one hole in the given bar pendulum. Okay. Now look at the experimental arrangement. So this is the bar pendulum. Okay. So on this metallic bar pendulum, so we have certain number of holes we can see, isn't it? So you can count the number of holes like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Okay, 10th one will be the center of gravity for you. Okay. Then one side we have 9 holes. Similarly on the other side also we have 9 holes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So you have to repeat the experiment. You have to take the time taken for oscillations for all the holes. Okay. So normally you consider the first hole as here. Distance of the first hole from center of gravity should be measured using the scale. So we have a meter scale like this. Okay. So should be kept from the center of gravity. Okay. So I will show you one side. So we can see that the distance between the two consecutive holes are 5 cm here. So distance of the first hole from center of gravity is equal to 5 cm, and similarly distance of the second hole from center of gravity is 10 cm, then 15 cm, then 20 cm, like that. So you just note down the distance of all the holes from center of gravity. Okay. Then you fix, it is already fixed to the ninth hole here. So what is that? So we have a hook fixed to the wall, and then we have a knife edge. Okay, it is passing through the ninth hole, and you look at the knife edge also. Okay, now this is the knife edge. So this knife edge is fixed by using the two nuts. Okay, on either side. So then you can hang over the hook. So once it is hang to the hook, okay, the knife edge is touching the flat surface of the hook here. Okay, then once you start the oscillation, so you should get the oscillation without any friction. That is called free oscillation should be obtained like this. Okay, then how to measure the time taken for attending oscillations? So we are using a digital stop clock. So initially it is showing 0, so you have to set it to 0. Then you just move the pendulum at one side and then leave it. So once it starts oscillating like this, free oscillations, okay, so parallel to the wall, then you just hold the digital stop clock and start when the pendulum comes at one side. Okay, start 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, now this is the time taken for 10 oscillations. How much it is? 16.07 seconds. Okay, so this value must be entered into the tabular column. Now repeat the experiment for second hole by removing this knife edge. Okay, fix it to the second hole and repeat the experiment. Fix it to third hole and then repeat the experiment. Like that, you complete the readings as shown in the tabular column for all 9 holes at one side. After completion of the experiment, you have to write the result as parallel axis theorem for moment of inertia is verified as T square D versus D square. That graph is actually giving a straight line with an intercept. Okay, and using that intercept, you are calculating the moment of inertia, that is called IG graphically. And similarly, using mass, length and breadth also, we calculated the moment of inertia, that is considered IG by calculation. Okay, so these two values must be entered here for comparison. Okay, so that verifies the parallel axis theorem. Okay, clear? Okay, thank you.